वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू अगेन इन ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ डिजिटल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड लॉजिक डिज़ाइन। सो नाउ टुडेज टॉपिक इज लॉजिक गेट्स। ओके, सो व्हाट इज अ लॉजिक गेट्स? सो व्हाट एवर द बूलियन इक्वेशन और द लॉजिकल इक्वेशन और एनी एक्सप्रेशन दैट वी हैव सीन इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स, so that equation can be implemented by using the logic gates. Okay, means we can implement any equation in practically by using the logic gates. So now there are two types of logic gates. So first type is, it is basic gates, and second type is universal gates. Now again, in basic gates it consists of AND gate, okay, OR gate, NOT gate, then XOR gate, XNOR gate. Okay, so these are the basic gates, and universal gates, there are two universal gates. So first one is NAND gate and NOR gate. So these two gates are called as a universal gates. Why it is called as a universal gates? Because by using only any one of these gates we can implement any of these gates, so that's why it is called as a universal gates. Suppose for example, if we want to perform AND operation, so we will use only NAND gates to perform AND operation. Okay, so that's why it is called as what? Universal gates. Again, same, if we want to perform AND operation, but instead of using AND gate we will use what? NOR gate only. So by using NOR gate only we will implement the AND gates, so that's why the NOR gate is also called as a universal gates. So why these gates are called as a universal gate? Because by using any one of them we can implement either AND gate, OR gate, NOR gate, XOR gate or XNOR gates. So that's why these two gates are called as what? Basic gates. Now let us see the truth table of these gates. Okay, as we know that the truth table is graphical representation of the input applied and their corresponding outputs. So first we will consider the AND gate. Okay, so AND gate is used to perform bit by bit AND operation. AND gate is used to perform bit by bit AND operation. The symbol of AND gate is like this. Okay, so here two inputs are there, A, B, and this is output Y. So this gate will be referred as what? AND gate. Okay, here two inputs are there, input A, B, and output is Y. So in AND gate, AND operation is performed, and AND operation is referred as what? Y equal to A and B. Here dot will indicates AND operation, A and B. Okay, now let us see the truth table. Suppose here we have two variable, input A, B, and output is Y. Okay, now two inputs are there, so how many possible combinations? 2 raised to 2, that is equal to 4. So possible inputs are either 0 0, okay, 0 1 1 0, and 1 1. So these are the possible inputs. Okay, so here we have to write the output Y. Here 0 0 0.0, that is equal to 0 0.1, that is equal to 0 1.0, that is equal to again 0 1.1, that is equal to 1. Okay, so this is what the truth table of AND gate. Truth table of what? AND gate. Now, how to remember the truth table for AND gate? The statement is what? The output is equal to 1 only if both the inputs are 1. Okay, what you have to remember in case of AND gate? The output of AND gate is 1 if both inputs are 1. That statement you have to remember only. So for AND gate, output equal to 1 if both inputs equal to 1. So you have to remember this statement. So this is about what AND gate. Now let us see the second gate, that is OR gate. Second gate is what? OR gate. And the symbol of OR gate is like this. So this is what the symbol of OR gate. Here we will suppose again consider the same inputs AB and output is Y. Now in OR gate, the output Y is equal to A OR B. Okay, A OR B. So plus sign is used to indicate OR operation. Here this multiplication or dot is indicate to represent AND operation. So this is what? Y equal to A plus B. Now let us draw the truth table of OR gate. So here also we have two inputs AB and the output is Y. So again possible cases are 00, 01, 10 or 11. So these are the possible cases. Now 0 plus 0, that is 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. Here you have to remember that the 1 plus 1, that is equal to 1. Okay, 1 plus 1 is 1. Actually it's not addition operation, because when we perform the addition operation, suppose for example I will show you, suppose if we perform addition operation 1 plus 1, that time 1 plus 1 is 0 and carry is 1, so the result is 0 for addition. But here the operation is OR operation, so 1 OR 1, that is equal to 1. Now how to remember this table for the OR gate? So in this case you have to remember the statements like the output of OR gate equal to 0 only if both the inputs are 0, otherwise it is 1. Output of OR gate is 0 only if both inputs are 0 0. Here you will see both the inputs are 0, then output is 0, otherwise it is what? 1. So for OR gate, what you have to remember? Output equal to 0 for or if both or all inputs, both input equal to 0. Otherwise it is 1. So you need to remember this statement here, otherwise that is equal to 0. Okay, so this is about what OR gate. Now our last gate is what? NOT gate. Actually these are the basic gates. NOT gate. NOT gate is also called as an inverter. Okay, NOT gate is also called as what? Inverter. And the symbol of NOR gate is like this. This is a buffer and the bubble is connected at the output of buffer. So this circle will indicates what? It is bubble. Suppose input A is applied. For NOT gate, it consists of only one input and the output is Y. So NOT gate is used to perform the or to carry out the complement of input. So here input is A, so what is the complement of A? It is A bar, or sometimes it may be referred as A dash also. Okay, so input is A, output is A bar. Now let us see the truth table. So only one input is there. So for one input, how many combinations are there? Either A equal to 0 or A equal to 1, and this is output Y. Now if input is 0, output is what? Complement. Output Y is what? A bar. So A bar is 1. If input is 1, then output is what? 0, because output is complement of input. Okay, so here in this way you have to remember all these truth table. Okay, so next gate is XOR, or it is also referred as a XOR. Next gate is XOR. The symbol of XOR is this one. So input are A, B, output is Y. So this gate is used to perform the XOR operation. So what is XOR operation that we are discuss in the truth table? So input are A, B, and output is Y. Two inputs are there, so possible condition 00, 01, 10, 11. Here the XOR operation is indicated as, suppose Y equal to A XOR B. This is what? A XOR B. This circle will indicate XOR operation. So in this case you have to remember this statement: if both the inputs are same, if both the inputs are same, then output is 0, otherwise it is 1. So for first case, here the inputs are 0 0, both inputs are same, A is 0, B is 0, so output is what? 0, as per the statement. So both inputs are 0, then output is 0. Here the inputs are not same, A is 0, B is 1, so output is 1. Here A is 1 and B is 0, again both are not same, so output is 1. And for last case, A equal to 1, B equal to 1 means what? Both the inputs are same, and if both the inputs are same, the output must be 0. So this is what? The truth table of XOR gate. How to remember this table? As per this statement, if both the inputs are same, if both the inputs are same, then output is 0, here 0, 0, and remaining, otherwise it is 1. So here we will write this statement: if both inputs equal to, if both the inputs are equal, then output equal to 0, otherwise equal to 1. So this is about what? XOR gate. Now the next gate is XNOR gate. It is also referred as a XNOR. So symbol of XNOR gate is like this: input are A, B, output is Y. So this gate will exactly work as this gate, but the output is inverted form. Here bubble is there at the output of this gate. If you only consider this one, then that is what? It is XOR gate. But here output, at the output side the bubble is connected, so the output is inverted. So here the output is what? A XOR B and then its complement. A XOR B and its complement, because of this bubble. Now for this, how to remember the table? So here A, B, output Y. So possible cases 00, 01, 10, 11. These are the possible cases. Now for the XNOR gate, the statement you have to remember, like if both the inputs are equal, if both the inputs are equal, then output is 1. Okay, otherwise it is 0. Here both the inputs are same, the output is 1. Here both the inputs are same, so output is 1. Otherwise it is 0. Here inputs are not same, so we will write here what? 0. So these outputs are exactly opposite to this one. Okay, so Y is inverted here because of this bar or because of this bubble. So this is all about what? XNOR gate. Here we will remember the truth table using the statement like if both input are same, then output equal to 1, otherwise that is equal to 0. Okay, so that is about what XNOR gate. Now let us see the universal gate. So first universal gate, that is NAND gate. The first universal gate is what? NAND gate. Now NAND gate is the combination of AND gate and NOT gate, that we have already studied. Here we have studied the AND gate and NOT gate. So this is AND gate. This is AND gate and this one is NOT gate. So if we combine these two gates, then let us see what will happen. So first we will perform the addition of these two gates, AND gate. This is AND gate. Input are considered as a AB. This is output Y. The output of this gate is connected to input of the second gate, that is NOT gate, and here you will get Y bar. Okay, so if we reduce this design part, then it will be indicated as, okay, so this reduction will be indicated as just bubble at the output side of this AND gate. Here input AB, because this NOT gate is also referred as this bubble. So here you will get Y output Y equal to, so what is the output of AND gate? AND gate's output is A dot B. Okay, A dot B, and this bubble will perform the complement of this product. So output Y equal to what? A dot B bar. Okay, so let us see the truth table. So here input A, input B, and the output is Y. Now possible cases are 00, 01, 10, 11. Okay. Now use this formula to find out the output values Y. 0.0, 0, and its complement. Suppose for example here we will find initially instead of A we will find here A dot B, and after that we will find here A dot B bar. Okay, so A dot B, 0.0, 0, this is what the output of AND gate. This is what the output of AND gate. So for AND gate we have a statement, if both the inputs are 1, then output is 1. Both the inputs are 1, then output is 1, otherwise it is 0, as per the statement of AND gate. Okay, and here you will see A dot B bar is there, so we have to just take the complement of this value. So the value is 1 1 1 0. So this is what the output of NAND gate. This is what the output of NAND gate. So what is the statement for NAND gate? If both the inputs are same, sorry, if both the inputs are 1, 1, then output is 0, otherwise it is 1. So statement for NAND gate is what? If both inputs are 1, then output is 0. In case of AND gate, if both the inputs are 1, that time we will get the output as a 1. Okay, and here we will get output as a 0, because here we have taken the complement of output of AND gates. So that's why the output is 0. And otherwise it is 1. So this is about what the NAND gate. Okay. Now the next gate is NOR gate. Next gate is what? NOR gate. Here also the NOR gate is a combination of OR gate and NOT gate. So OR gate we have already studied. So the symbol of OR gate is like this. This is AB. This is the output of OR gate. Okay, and that output is connected to NOT gate. Here Y, here we will get Y bar. So here Y equal to what? A plus B, and here we will get Y equal to what? A plus B whole term bar, because this will acts as what? NOT gate. If you reduce the diagram, then we will indicate this as, this is A B, and just we will replace this NOT gate symbol by using the bubble. Your bubble will indicate NOT gate. So Y equal to what? A plus B whole term bar. Okay, so this is NOR gate. Let us see the truth table. So here again the inputs are 2, A, B, and the output is Y. So possible cases 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So here first we will find the output of OR gate, that is A plus B, and after that we will find A plus B bar. So here you need to write the values for what? This gate, OR gate. Then we will take the complement, then we will get the output of what? NOR gate. So for OR gate the statement is what? If both the inputs are 0, 0, if both the inputs are 0, 0, output is 0, otherwise it is 1. So according to the statement of OR gate, here the value is 0, otherwise it is 1, 1, 1. Okay, and this is what? The complement of this value. So here 1, triple 0. So what is the statement for NOR gate? If both the inputs are 0, 0, then output is 1, otherwise it is 0. So for NOR gate, the statement is, if both input equal to 0, then output equal to what? 1. Otherwise output equal to what? 0. So this is a statement. Now for all these examples we have taken only two inputs, that's why here we have used the term both. Okay, if you have three variable or four variable, that time you have to refer this term as what? If all inputs, okay, if the inputs are more than two, that time you have to replace this both by all. Because if we consider the word both, that time only two variables are there. If we have maximum variables, that time we will use what? If all the inputs are 0, 0, or if all the inputs are 1, 1, like this. Okay. Now let us see some examples that means from any given boolean or logical equation, how to draw the logic diagram using the basic or universal gates. So first suppose we will consider the one example like Y equal to A B C plus A B bar C plus A B C bar. Okay, so this is what? The given equation, and we have to implement this equation using the logic gates. Okay, means we have to write or we have to draw the logic diagram. So how to write? So whenever the product term is there, okay, so product term here we have three product terms. How many product terms are there? Three product terms. So for product term we will use which gate? For product term we will use which gate? AND gate. Okay, so for this performing the product we will use what? AND gate. And for performing, so I will let us write here. So for these terms we have to use AND gates. And for these two, this is what? Addition term, no, sum term. So for performing sum operation we will use OR gates. So initially you need to find out the number of gates required. So how many product terms are there in this equation? 1 2 3. Okay, so 1 2 3, how many AND gates are required? Here 3 AND gates are required. But again here if you see the input variables, are how many variables are there? A, B, C. So 3 variables are there. So we need these 3 AND gates in which form? 3 input AND gate form. So we will require 3 input AND gates. 3 input AND gate is required. OR gate. Okay, how many summation terms are there here? 2. So here we require 2 what? OR gate. 2 OR gate. Now let us draw the logic diagram. So initially how many literals are there? 3 literals. So here we will write literal A, B, C. Here we will draw the lines. These are the inputs. Okay, here we are using 3 input AND gate. So first term we will perform ABC. So first we will take one AND gate. The input for this AND gate is this term ABC. So here A, B and C, and the output of this first gate, suppose it will be referred as a y1. So what is y1? It is A dot B dot C, ABC term. Second term A B bar C. So here we will take another AND gate. First input is A, so A is directly connected to the input of this second gate. Second term is B bar. Okay, now here B bar is there. So for making the complement of B, okay, here we have left one gate also. We have to use here NOT gate because the complement term is also there. So for complement term we have to use NOT gate. So two terms are complemented here, so we require two NOT gate also here. Okay, so we required a complement of B. So for complement of B we use here NOT gate. So this is what? B bar. And third term is what? C. So output, suppose it is y2. So what is the term? A is directly connected into, this is what? B bar. Here NOT gate is connected, so it is B bar into. Third, C is directly connected, so A B bar C. And last gate, the input are A B C bar. A is directly connected, B is also directly connected, but C bar is there. So C is first connected to NOT gate and then connected to input of AND gate. So this is suppose y3. So terms are A, B, C bar. Now all these terms are what? All these terms are added together. So here Now suppose we have three input OR gate, that time we can directly connect what? Single OR gate. So three input gate is there, so here we will require only one OR gate. Okay, here require only one OR gate as we have three input gate. So the output final Y, that is equal to addition of this three, means what? Y equal to Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3. So Y equal to ABC plus Y2 is what? AB bar C plus AB C bar. So that is what? The given equation. So like this we will implement any logical equation into the logic diagram. Now suppose if we do not have three input AND gate, so whenever we are actually performing the practicals of this subject, that time we don't have the three input AND gate, because the gates are available in the IC form, and that IC we have in our lab, that is two input gates. So that time how to design this logic diagram? So here suppose I will show you how to design the same one. Suppose here consider the two inputs. Here suppose input first AND gate is connected with the two inputs, so this is AB. Okay, and the third term is what? C. So the output of this gate is what? It is A into B. Now the third input, that is C, again connected to, sorry, AND gate is there, again second AND gate. So the output of this AND gate is what? The first input is what? AB, and the third input is C. So this is ABC. So in this way we will form this whole term AB and C. Okay, now suppose this second term we have to implement, then how to implement it? So here the input are A, second input is B bar is there, so here we will add one NOT gate. So the output of this is what? A into B bar. Now again this output we have to add with what? The third input, that is C. So here we will add the C. So the output is what? A B bar. A B bar, and third is what? C. A B bar C. Okay, like this we will form the third term also, and finally all these terms are OR together by using the OR gate. Okay, so that is about the how to implement any logical or Boolean equation by using the logic diagram. Okay, so for the today's lecture we will stop here. If you have any doubts regarding to the lecture, you can ask me in the comment section, or you can ask me personally on the WhatsApp also. If you like my video, please like it, and if you have not subscribed to this channel, so I request you to please subscribe it, and also press the bell icon, so whenever my new videos will be there on YouTube, so you will get the notified. So thank you so much.